Find the number of possible integral values of x and y which satisfies 5x plus 9y equal to 7 given that minus 500 is less than x is less than 500 and minus 500 is less than y is less than 500. This problem was sent to us by one of our students who appeared in CDS 1 2020, and this was one of a very good problem, and this problem was time taking in the examination. So let us see how to solve this question. Here we are given three conditions. First one is 5x plus 9y is equal to 7, and the other two conditions are given here. Those conditions are for the range of values of x and y. X and y lies with from minus 500 to 500, and here we need to find basically the number of possible integral values of x and y which satisfies all these three conditions. So here we can write it as x is equal to 7 minus 9y over 5. Now it is given that we need to focus on the integral values. So if we need to get an integral value of x, then what is the condition for this RHS term? So here 7 minus 9y, it needs to be completely divisible by 5. Okay, so in order to get this condition as true, we need to have unit digit of 7 minus 9y as 0 or 5, because only then that number will be divisible by 5 completely. Okay, so let us now look for the values of y for which 7 minus 9y ends with a 0 or a 5. So let us write here for the value of y, and here it is 7 minus 9y. So if you have value of y as 3, 9y will be 27, and this 7 minus 9y, that will be ending with a 0. And if you are having this y as 8, then this 9y will end like 72, and this 7 minus 9y, it will end with a 5. And now if I talk about this series, then you can certainly get these unit digit values as 0 and 5 for this entire series, that is 3, 8, 13, 18, 23 and 28 and so on. Okay, and if I talk in the negative values, then if I can add 3 to this 7, then it will end with a value whose unit digit is 0. So we need to have the value of 9y as something that is ending with a 3, and it is in negative terms. So if I get here a minus 7, for the value of y as minus 7, it will end with a 3, and that value will be negative. So we can add it with 7 and it will end in a 0. And again, for the value of y as minus 2, we can have a value here that will be negative, and the unit digit of the value will be 8, and that number will also end with a 5, so that it will be divisible by 5 and it will give integer value of x. Okay, so now here we can generalize it, minus 17, minus 27 and so on, and here also minus 12, minus 22 and so on. For these kind of values we will get the integral values of x, and obviously we are talking about the integral values of y. So here, if you can notice, we are getting a arithmetic progression for the values of y, and the progression is minus 7, minus 2, 3, 8, 13 and so on. Here you can see this is an arithmetic progression with a common difference of 5. Okay, now what we need to find is the value of the last term and the value of the first term of this series, so that we can find the number of terms in the series. That will be our answer. Okay, so let us now focus on how to find the last term and the first term of the series. Here you can see that 5x is equal to 7 minus 9y, and the value of x, it ranges from minus 500 to 500. So if I put the value of x as minus 500, then the value of 7 minus 9y, that will be greater than. Here what I am doing is I am just simply putting up this 5x in this inequality. I am multiplying all these three terms by 5 and I am replacing it with 7 minus 9y. So this is what we are solving here. Minus 2500 is less than 7 minus 9y. It will be less than 2500. And here what you can do, so you can write it like minus 9y, it is greater than minus 2507 and it is less than 2493. And as you know, as we have learnt in our junior classes, that if we are changing the sign from negative to positive, then the sign of the inequality will also change. So here it will become 9y, it is greater than minus 2493 and it is less than 2507. Okay, and you can simply divide both of these terms by 9. Here I will erase this portion so that I can write here. So here I can write it like minus 2493 over 9, it is less than y, it is less than 2507 upon 9. So for y we are getting the values as minus 277 and here it will be less than 278.55 and so on. So here you can see the value of y, we are getting the range for the value of y, and here you can see this number minus 277, it will be ending with 7, but we won't be including it. So the first term of the series will be minus 272 and the last term of the series will be 278. As the value of y needs to be less than 278.55, so 278 is less than this number, so we will definitely say that the last term will be 278, as we are looking for the terms ending with 8 in the positive domain. Okay, so here we have obtained our arithmetic progression and we can simply solve it. We can write, as you all know, the formula for arithmetic progression, that is last term. As we know the formula for arithmetic progression, that is an is equal to a1, that is the first term, plus n minus 1 times d. Here the d is the common difference and n is the number of term. So we can simply put the values. 278 is equal to 2 minus 272 plus n minus 1 times 5. And after taking this minus 272 here, you can simply write 278 plus 272, that will be equal to n minus 1 times of 5. So you can simply add it up, that is 0, 5 and 5, that will be equal to n minus 1 times 5. So here you can obtain this as n minus 1 is equal to 110 and you can say n is equal to 111, that is 111. So there are 111 possible integral values of x and y which satisfy all these conditions. So this was the solution to this question. I hope you understood it. If there is any problem, then leave a comment and also like this video. If you like it, then definitely press the like button and comment on this video if you have any confusion at all. And don't forget to subscribe our channel, that is Pendulum EDU, and press the bell icon. Thank you so much for watching this video.